Hello everyone, welcome to your very own channel Sony Sing Physics. In this video, I have discussed a very important question from your alternative to practical paper, paper 6-2, which is a planning question. If you are able to understand this question, this will help you to answer one question from your paper 4-2 also, which is extended one. In this video, I have highlighted some of your very common mistakes, what you do, my dear children, and how to overcome from that. Then I have taken one sample paper and I have exactly compared the question with the mark scheme. So you will understand that how the marks is distributed among different parts of question. So please watch it carefully, and if you have any doubt regarding the content of this or any from anywhere from the physics, you can write in comment box. So let's watch it. Students often write too much. They begin by repeating much of the introduction to the question, including the list of apparatus provided. How? Just see here. This is the question, and if you look at in the question, the apparatus available includes metal balls of different sizes, a tray of dry sand. So these are already given in question, but when we see students' response, this highlighted one is the student response. Student wrote, he will need a meter rule and a clamp and stand and a tray of dry sand and a metal ball. Here, metal ball, dry sand and tray is already given in question, but student have mentioned in apparatus required, which is unnecessary. Spending lots of time on introduction, students writes an account without apparently referring to the bullet points, which are there to help you to structure your answer. This results in a rambling account which often missed vital elements such as the measurements that must be taken. So if we are not referring those bullet points, then our answer will be incomplete and important things will be missed out. These are the bullet points which students should refer for planning. So all of you can read it. I'm not going to read all of them, otherwise this video will be quite long. So you can read, my dear students, by your own. In this type of investigation question, students often offer a prediction which is not asked for and then do not offer an explanation of how to reach a conclusion which is required. So we should avoid writing prediction unless until it is asked in question. General precautions that apply to most experiments, example, how to avoid parallax error, are not required, but candidates should offer precautions such that are specific to the investigation. For example, in this investigation, flattening the surface of the sand before each trial. This is one sample question. As per question, a student investigates the strength of wires made from different metals by measuring the force required to break the wires. And this is the diagram. And these are the bullet points what we need to use for plan an experiment to investigate the force required to break wires made from different metals. Here I have compared mark scheme and bullet points which is asked in the question. And as per my observation, each bullet point contains one mark. So if you are referring each point at least once in your answer, then minimum 5 marks you will get in your planning question. So let's see that. I will tell you in detail how it is. First is, write a list of suitable metals for the wires you would investigate. And one mark is for that. Name at least 3 metals. Okay. Then second one is, explain briefly how you would do the investigation. So mark 2, 3 and 4 is for how you are doing investigation. So this is called method, and method contain 3 marks. Then third bullet point is, state the key variables that you would keep constant. So mark 5 is for that, that is control variable. So whatever you need to mention over there. Then fourth bullet point is, draw a table or tables or column headings. So if you look at mark 6, MP6, Then one mark is for table. Then the last one explains how you would use the results to reach a conclusion. So MP7 one mark is for that. So as per this, method contain 3 mark and rest each of the bullet contain one mark. So if you are careful while answering your planning answer, definitely you will be able to score full 7 mark in this question, which will be a good score. I hope this video will be helpful for you and you are able to score a very good marks in your coming examination, and all the best for your exams. Thank you.